In the NBA, the act of ring chasing is defined as a process by which a player signs with a team that is heavily stacked and a top favorite with the goal of winning a championship in the least amount of effort as possible. Typically, a guy who becomes a ring chaser is frowned upon since he's looked at as a traitor, a person who shows no loyalty, someone who looks to take the easy way out, etc. 9 times out of 10, a ring chaser does end up being successful and finds himself with a ring, but for that other 1 time out of 10, a ring chaser ends up being on the wrong side, basically sacrificing his reputation for nothing. One unfortunate example of that was Anderson Varejao back in the 2015-2016 NBA season. And let's just say that he probably had the worst luck out of any player in NBA history that has tried to chase a ring. So we'll be looking into that year and how Anderson Varejao became practically the unluckiest player in NBA history. Before I move on, I just want to remind you guys to just leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications if you haven't done so already, so that you can receive alerts for future content and so that other amazing viewers like you on YouTube can find this video. Appreciate the support, and let's move on. Anderson Varejao came into the league as one of the best basketball players from Brazil. He started playing professional basketball at the age of 16, and until the time he turned 20, Varejao was the most dominant center in the Brazilian professional leagues, where he averaged a near double-double at 18 points, 10 rebounds, along with 3 blocks per game. For the following 2 years after that, he moved on to playing in the EuroLeague for FC Barcelona, where he wasn't as dominant but put up average numbers at his position. For a guy his size, he was pretty strong and he was an excellent rebounder at 6'11", which helped to propel FC Barcelona to winning its first 2 ever EuroLeague championships. After his second year in the EuroLeague is when Anderson Varejao decided to declare for the 2004 NBA draft, where he would be selected by the Orlando Magic with the 30th overall pick. Varejao wouldn't end up playing for the Magic, of course, since 29 days later, he was sent over to the Cleveland Cavaliers in a trade that included a player and 2 second round picks. For the first 7 years of his career, Anderson Varejao put up averages of 7 points, 7 rebounds, and 1 assist on 52% shooting from the field. During that 7-year span from 2004 to 2011, Anderson Varejao ended up going to the finals with the Cavs in 2007, along with being named to an all-defensive second team in 2010. Varejao wasn't putting up huge numbers since he wasn't that type of star guy, but he suited his role well as a normal rotation player who came off the bench for Cleveland. It wasn't until the 2012-2013 season when Anderson Varejao started to put up double digits in both points and rebounds, but the unfortunate thing about all of it was that he was averaging career highs in a limited number of games due to injuries he suffered to his foot and a blood clot found in his lung, and from then on, he never put up the same numbers. Let's fast forward to the 2015-2016 NBA season, a time that was probably the unluckiest year of Anderson Varejao's career. So, at the start of the season, Anderson Varejao finds himself on a new Cavaliers team with a prime LeBron that just went to the finals the prior year. The Cavs had arguably the best big three in the entire league in LeBron, Kyrie, and Kevin Love, and they were determined to have a finals rematch that year. Unlike the past few seasons at that point for Varejao, the fortunate thing was that he was fully healthy and was ready to play big minutes for Cleveland. In fact, even though he didn't play a ton of minutes each game, Varejao was able to play in 24 of the Cavs' first 31 games. At that point, Cleveland had the best record in the Eastern Conference. Of course, there are other great teams out in the West like the Invincible Warriors and the Spurs, but the Cavs at the moment didn't seem like they had any real competition in the East. Things were seemingly going well for Anderson Varejao until the trade deadline on February 18th, 2016, when Cleveland decided to move in another direction, sending Varejao to the Portland Trail Blazers for a future second round pick. At that instance, Varejao's situation seemed to go from good to bad, looking as the Trailblazers were an average team in the West, but they obviously stood no chance against the top teams in the league. Fortunately for Varejao, Portland would end up waiving him, which made Varejao a free agent, so he had the option of signing with any team that he wanted. The squad he decided to go with was the Golden State Warriors, a team that was 48-4 at the time, and were on pace to break the Chicago Bulls' 72-win record. Even though what he did was technically considered ring chasing, since everyone already assumed that the Warriors were the favorites to win the title, but it was practically the best move for Varejao, as he seemingly went from a good situation in Cleveland to an even better one in Golden State. With the contribution of Anderson Varejao, who played 22 games with the squad, the Warriors ended up going a record 73-9 and had the best record in the entire league. Golden State got past the first two rounds of the 2016 playoffs rather easily, but it was in the Western Conference Finals where the Warriors had their biggest challenge. In a matchup against the Oklahoma City Thunder, Golden State would fall down a 3-1 deficit in the series, and most of that was a result of the fatigue and mounting injuries that the team sustained from all the effort that they put in the regular season. It was at this point where Varejao was starting to regret his decision of actually signing with the squad, but fortunately, the Warriors were able to pull away and come back down from a 3-1 lead to beat the Thunder to advance to the NBA Finals, where they would be matched up against Varejao's former team, the Cleveland Cavaliers. In the same season, Cleveland had an easier time than Golden State in the weak Eastern Conference, and they were able to breeze all the way to the finals in just 14 games. But going into the finals, the Cavs were the heavy underdogs throughout the entire series. No one was expecting them to beat a team that had the all-time record for wins in a single season, along with two of the greatest shooters of all time. For Anderson Varejao, he was somewhat in a weird position. He was playing against a team he gave his entire heart to for 12 years that traded him the same season, yet he was on arguably the greatest team that gave him the best chance at winning a ring. For the moment, there was nothing to worry about, especially when the Warriors were up 3-1 on his former team. No team in the finals had ever come back down from 3-1, so Varejao's championship ring was already secured. Except that wasn't the case. Draymond Green ended up being suspended for Game 5 of the series. Andrew Bogut was later ruled out for the rest of the finals with a knee injury. Plus, a lot of their main guys like Curry and Iguodala were banged up and weren't playing at their peak levels. In what would end up as a worst case scenario, the Cavs would end up winning Games 5 and 6 at home and on the road, and in what was the most crucial Game 7 in recent history, with the score tied at 89 with close to a minute left, Kyrie Irving ends up hitting the shot of all shots that would send Cleveland its first ever championship and make Golden State have the most disappointing season of all time. Most of all, it made Anderson Varejao one of the more unfortunate players that year. He started out on a great team, then signed with what he believed was a better team, and ended up not winning anything at all. One of the most heartbreaking moments in recent history. But that's not the only thing that went wrong for Varejao, since he re-signed with the Warriors in the 2016 offseason, the same offseason when the team acquired Kevin Durant, and at that point, there is no doubt that the Warriors were going to be champions the next season. Even though he missed out the season before, the road was looking much better for Varejao. At least, that was what he thought until he was waived again after only playing 15 games with the Warriors. And following his departure, Golden State went on to go 24-8, finishing the season at 67-15 at first in the West, and in the 2017 postseason, the Warriors swept through the first three rounds, and in a finals matchup against the Cavs, Golden State easily won in 5 games, earning their second title in 3 years, and finishing the playoffs with a record of 16-1. After he was waived that season, Varejao wouldn't play again in the NBA for nearly 4 years. Instead, he was playing overseas in the Brazilian Basketball League. In the two opportunities where he had a clear chance to earn a ring, Varejao just sadly missed out, either because his teams waived him or due to some random miracle. The sad part about all of this is that Varejao has yet to earn a ring, and now that he's back in the NBA with the Cavs, hopefully he can find another chance at winning a title. That's the story of Anderson Varejao and how he became the unluckiest player in history due to one unfortunate season. But what do you think? Share your thoughts down in the comments, and I'd love to see what you put. If you enjoyed, please leave a like and subscribe, and turn on notifications to receive alerts for future videos. I'm out.